Hey everyone, it's Lindsay from Hazel Haven, and in today's lesson, I'm going to walk you through how to create a pinnable Pinterest graphic. So you basically want your Pinterest graphic to have three things. You want it to have an easy to read title, you want it to have a call to action or an opt-in. That could be a, you know, hey, click here to grab your free calendar, hey, click here to get your freebie, you know, whatever it is. You want it to somewhere have on your graphic that there's something for your audience to get on your post or on your website or whatever you have going on. The third thing you want it to have is your website. You want it to have the URL to your website, because that way if somebody saves it, then later on they know, oh yeah, this came from this website. And it's not just a pretty image and you have no idea where it's from. So, you know, that's just something that I recommend. So anyways, we're actually going to recreate this graphic. This is an actual pin that I have, and it's been pinned over 1,000 times. And I just wanted to, you know, kind of walk you through how I created it. So let's get started. Go to Canva, and I'm already logged in. As you see, you know, there's not a Pinterest graphic right here. So if you hit the plus sign on the right, you can go to Pinterest graphic and click on Pinterest graphic. We are going to go to elements on the left. We are going to grab a photo, this one that has a computer. So what I just clicked on it and it dropped in. And now I'm actually going to hit crop. And I'm going to crop the image so that it's in the same layout as the Pinterest graphic. And I'm just gonna click and drag it until it hits everything. As you see, I can't see what's right here. So down here on the right, you can zoom out and then you can see if it's where you want it to be. So I'm actually gonna hit this fit so that it fits in here and I can see everything. Okay, so the next thing I do is I add a shape. So go back to elements on the left, hit shape, and then just click and drag until your shape covers the whole graphic. I like to do this because it makes your words pop off of the screen, and then you click up here or it's this little gradient thing, and I'm gonna drop it down to maybe, I don't know, maybe like 80, let's do 85. I click to the side so it saves. Oh, you know what, guys, I forgot to name it. It's always a good idea to name your design when you get started in case your internet goes wonky and, you know, then your whole dashboard will be full of untitleds and you'll be like, what? But anyways, be sure to name your graphic. Okay, so let's carry on. So now we're going to add text. We're going to click on heading. Okay, so once you have your title in, you can go up and pick your brand fonts. If you don't have any brand fonts, then you might just, you know, find a font that's easy to read. Okay, and then I'm gonna put in plus sign. So what I did there is, you know, as you see, the text is all bunched together. You can hover over and drag it out so that it makes sense for your text box. And then you just kind of move it around until it centers. Okay, and then the last thing I'm gonna do is add my website. So I added my brand colors in, and now I'm just gonna, you know, highlight a few words that I wanna have more emphasis on. And by doing this, you just kind of select the ones you wanna pick, and then you change it. And then that way, as you see, look, I have three different colors within the same text box. That's just something that I like to do. You can keep it all black if you want. That works just as well. Okay, and the last thing I like to do, I go over to Elements, I click on Square again, and then I'm going to make this really thin, like it's just a little bar on the bottom of my graphic. And then I'm gonna make that color. Now look, when you're working with white, up here is where you can change your color. So it kind of blends in a little bit. So just be sure to, you know, look for that little square and then you can go in and change the color. Now, as you see, it's above the text. So I want to arrange it and push it back. So now it's behind the text and now I have a pinnable image. So, you know, guys, I really hope that that helped you just kind of walk through how to create a pinnable pin. And then once you're done, all you have to do is save it. So you just hit download and then save it. You can save it as a PNG for if you're going to pin it directly to Pinterest and you want it to have high quality. And if you're just going to use it for Facebook or you want to use just one image, you don't have to worry about it, everything. Just save it as a JPEG and that will work for both Pinterest and compressing on Facebook. Okay, everybody, so I have a little challenge for you. I want you to take action and identify a graphic that you want to either create or recreate. And then I want you to create that new Pinterest graphic in Canva, like I just showed you. It doesn't have to be, obviously, it does not have to be the same style that I did, but, you know, just kind of play around with it until you find something that you like. And then I want you to pin your new pin to Pinterest. And then I want you to share that same pin in the Facebook group. So I know that's a lot of Pinterest terminology, but hopefully that makes a little bit of sense. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing what you create. And if you have any questions, just let me know. I look forward to seeing your designs.